We discussed this at length 2 or 3 days ago, based on what is happening in other European countries, in Americas, regarding compounds that potentially could be able to treat COVID. And I'm glad to inform you that through the World Health Organization, Kenya has received approval to join the Solidarity Trial, and we have already obtained ethical approval. The compounds that we are going to deploy, of course, will depend on how available they are, how easily available they are in terms of compassionate use of the different drugs and protocols. And of course, it will also depend on the clinical presentation of our cases. As we all know, majority of our people tend to have a mild form of the disease. So if we are to go for very expensive compounds, which we could be able to apply for very small segment of the population, then we'll have to be able to make that judgment based on the numbers. But there are a whole range of compounds, antivirals, antiretrovirals, antimalarial drugs, which will form part of the arsenal that we are going to deploy to see what works best in our scenario. We have also gone ahead to develop guidelines and standards for all conditions, so that in case you have COVID in pregnancy, we have developed guidelines and protocols, which we have shared with our teams in the counties for easy application. And of importance is this issue of the children, because in today's press, we told you of a child who is just 6 months old who has tested positive. Most of the children tend to be totally asymptomatic. And because children tend to play with other children, they are potentially very, very good transmitters. So the message today is to ensure that you limit interaction between your children and others, and also ensure that children also undertake infection prevention control measures, including hand washing, using sanitizers. There are even children's face masks now in the market locally. And of course, practicing physical and social distancing. I just wanted also to emphasize on the issue of the refugees. You know, Kenya, we have hosted refugees over very many decades, especially from our neighbors in Somalia, Ethiopia, South Sudan, the DRC, Congo. And most of the refugee camps that we have, of course, are located along our border areas. And remember, our borders are porous, like if you go to Dadaab. And the infection now in Somalia, the numbers are increasing, and because of that ease of movement between Kenyan side and Somali side, that is why we decided to make a restriction in movement in Mandera County. Further, we have also started testing in Wajir County to be able to cover that northeastern part, so that samples don't have to be brought to Nairobi. We have also enhanced our surveillance capacity in the refugee camps, together with our partners, including UNHCR, World Vision, the Red Cross, AMREF, and all other players. Of course, capacity building is ongoing for healthcare workers who serve the refugee population to be able to assist them in case definition. And of course, we continue with our advocacy, community social mobilization, so that we have the refugees as part of us in the fight against COVID-19 disease. Thank you.